It's a tantalizing question. Who wants to be a millionaire? That was a smash success when it first came out on ABC. And our next guest says you won't find the answer on a game show. She should know. She made her first million in just 2 years.
Debt is a habit, and it has nothing to do with how much money you make.
Dani Johnson is a self-made multimillionaire and sought-after speaker. But you wouldn't know that from her past. Her parents were abusive drug addicts, and Dani was raised on welfare. She left home as a teen and became successful in sales. But she lost everything in a failed marriage and a bad business deal. At 21, Dani was homeless and living out of her car. So she started a business from the trunk of her car using a payphone. By the time she was 23, Dani was a millionaire.
Well, please welcome the author of a book called Spirit-Driven Success, Dani Johnson. Dani, so good to have you.
Thank you.
Hey, listen. Abusive relationship, left home as an early teenager, got into a bad marriage. Did you have a child?
Yes, I did.
You did?
Yes, I did. Didn't
want to have an abortion. You had a child?
No abortion.
And then you got married.
Yes.
To a con man.
Yes.
Who took all your money.
Yes. Could the story get any worse? Yes, so, it does.
Give it all up. I mean, you had every reason to just, you know, get in bed and pull the covers over you and
slice my wrists and,
you know,
overdose on drugs.
Like that.
I did. I actually was very suicidal. Actually, first time I tried to commit suicide, I was 6 years old. And then when I was 21, when my husband drained my bank account and maxed out my credit cards, when I'm, you know, completely homeless, literally homeless. Yeah. This isn't like a figurative speech. No, I was completely homeless. And then I was completely suicidal.
Well, you got into a, was it multi-level or health foods? Or it was a multi-level?
I actually got involved with a couple of different things. I actually even manufactured my own health and nutrition products
well.
Yes, I did, as well as a skincare line and
some herbal
stuff.
Back in your kitchen stirring up something?
No. Once I had gotten myself back on top financially, which took about a year. In fact, my first year, when I started a business from the trunk of my car in a payphone booth, I made $250,000, took that money, invested into manufacturing a long line of products, and went out
and
continued.
I mean, $250,000 in a year living out of your car? That's tough duty. How did you do it?
It was crazy. You know what? It's really funny. I had quite a wake-up experience with the Lord. I had done my first line of cocaine, and I was fiending for it the very next day. And that's one thing I said I would never do, because my parents did a lot of that stuff. And so I heard the voice of the Lord after diving into the water, after being very frustrated, not being able to find any more. And I heard him say, pick up your mat and walk.
Yeah.
The next day, I had just took an account for my life. What I have, what I did not have, what could I start with? And I started with nothing. I started with no brochures, no products, no physical address, no phone, no nothing. And just really through relationship marketing, really through using some skills that I had learned the year before from some multimillionaires, learn how to market, learn how to sell, learn how to follow up, learn how to train, learn how to do things like that. And $250,000 first year, and became a millionaire the second year.
Every possible excuse for failure you had, and there's so many people that'll run through that litany. Here's how come they can't succeed.
I know.
Pick up your mat and walk.
Yes. It really was about, you know, confronting my excuses and making a decision to never return to broke again. So many people today, Mr. Robertson, are in such financial terrible situation, just as I've been watching here on the show. I love what you're doing, that you're bringing that kind of knowledge to the public and around the world, because a lot of people just don't understand. What should I be doing right now? You know, a lot of, there is less food on the planet. I believe, honestly, the Lord is beginning to discipline. I believe that there was lots in the storehouses because it was preparation for a famine that we are currently in.
Right.
And if people don't wake up and get responsible, they don't start increasing their skill, they don't start learning what they need to immediately, they're going to wind up on the bad side of that famine instead being a Joseph who prospered during that famine.
What are some of these principles these millionaires taught you about selling and training and all that?
You know what? To be quite honest with you, most of what is out there that's being sold in training seminars or sold in motivational seminars, honestly, is a bunch of hooey. That's the truth. It is. It's really sad. And unfortunately, people are paying thousands of dollars, $1,000 for a weekend, $5,000 for a weekend, and to learn what? Nothing. It's mostly about hype. It's mostly about, oh, believe that you can and you will, or, you know, setting your mind on meditating on millions. I'm here to tell you that's not how I did it. That's not how I did it at all. You know, I was in a mess. Really, the truth is that people need to advance their skill. The Bible talks about that in Matthew 25, 14. It talks about the parable of the talents. And the very first part of it, it says that the master gave each according to his own ability. And so ability is skill. In Ecclesiastes 10, it says that skill produces success. Yeah. The Bible says in Proverbs that diligent hands produce wealth. Right. There are 1,500 scriptures that talk about money. Christians, unfortunately, only know the bad ones that say, oh, it's much harder for a rich man to get to heaven than it is for a camel to get in the eye of a needle, or whatever. The truth is they only focus on the bad ones instead of understand that God has a plan for our finances, and I'm not a prosperity gospel teacher. Mm-hmm. There is truth to what I'm saying in that if you increase your skill, if you want to learn how to make money, you better learn from people that know how.
Sure.
Don't go ask an opinion of someone that's broke. You need to study people that have the skills.
Most of their friends in the church
are broke. They're all broke, and they know all the good scriptures that justify them staying broke.
Sure.
But the truth is what kind of influence do we have being broke? What kind of influence, like what you were just saying on the last segment, this is a time for Christians to rise up.
Yeah.
This is a time. I believe that God right now is looking for a peculiar people. I believe He's looking for a people, especially in the marketplace. We have seen tens of thousands of souls be won into the kingdom of heaven. Mm-hmm. Just last weekend, I was in Chicago. In fact, 2 weeks from now, I'll be in Portland, Oregon, May 2nd and 3rd, doing the same seminar. We had hundreds of deliverances right there in a business seminar. Give me a break. People being set free, not only learning financial tips, but those things that hinder them and being able to get over those things and being able to learn what's causing bad relationships, which being able to teach them why are they staying stuck in a career where they don't belong. I believe God wants to raise people up to a very high influential position because they carry the Spirit of Christ, the hope of glory, because He that is in us is stronger than he that is in the world. And I believe that He wants to raise up a people that others will say, how are you prospering right now? How is this famine missing you? How are you carrying this joy? What is your life about? I believe He's looking for that people, and I believe that if we're broke, we're going to look like everybody else.
Well, if you're drowning, you have a hard time helping a drowning man. It's better to be in the boat to pull him up in there with you.
In fact, I think you'll drown also.
That's right.
Yeah,
you'll drown together.
That's right.
Well, what's going on with you?
You know what? God has just been so amazing and beautiful and wonderful. I mean, to take someone like me who was a homeless woman and not, you know, yes, I made $1 million by my second year, but I've made millions and millions of dollars since then. And it hasn't happened.
Did you keep it?
Yes, this time. Praise God. Yeah. First time around, I lost it because I didn't understand the principles that were in the Word of God and also the principles. I brought you a gift.
Oh,
I brought
you
a gift for you, and I've got a bunch more here for a few of your staff as well as for your viewers right now.
Good.
If they go to our website, which is DaniJohnson.com, this is going to cover those 10 keys to wealth as well as 7 keys to poverty. You learn what causes poverty, then you can kind of stay away from those things.
That's right.
Learn what causes wealth scripturally, as well as advancing their skill.
Conquering the Financial Kingdom.
Yes.
And your book, Spirit-Driven Success, is this available? Where can people get it?
That is available at DaniJohnson.com. And apparently you guys have a link at CBN.com as well, where they can get a hold of that. It's not available in bookstores. Mr. Robertson, look what God has done. We self-published. That book came out January 2nd in 90 days, 60,000 copies sold because God has taken that message. Not because we're so great at what we do, but we have a God that is so faithful because we've been diligent with the small things. He's been able to promote that book worldwide.
You're a human dynamo, and I'm glad the Lord's got His hand on you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much. Dani Johnson, ladies and gentlemen, you say that you're going to give one of these to people?
We're going to give it away for free. If they're willing to just go ahead and pay the shipping cost out to them, if they go to my website right now, for your viewers that are watching from all over the world, this is a $30 item. It is practical, simple steps on how to be able to accumulate wealth right there on that CD for free.
Dani, D-A-N-I, Johnson.
Yep.
.com?
That's right.
Okay, you got it. Dani, you're terrific. Thank you so much.
God bless you. Thank you.
May you continue to prosper.
Thank you, sir.